We'd like to welcome all the students from different colleges of Mumbai and from different colleges of Maharashtra. And we would also like to invite all the special guests and dignitaries present here this evening for our 123rd Prerana Festival. It has been over 10 to 11 years that we have been conducting this festival and this program. And it has been an incredible privilege to be witness to the growing numbers of the students despite the India-Zimbabwe match. They are still here. They are here because India-Zimbabwe match is over. If the match was on, I would be the only one talking about master strokes in life to myself. So indeed, it's very overwhelming to see this wonderful response. My special welcome to some of our very special dignitaries. Today we have with us from the previous Indian cricket team, Shriman Pavin Praveen Ambreji, present here. And it's quite embarrassing for me to sit here and talk on cricket when he is present. Well, and I don't know much cricket anyways. And I would also like to welcome a special guest here this evening, Mr. Rajay Ambresh Raoji, who comes from the royal family of Aheri and is currently the Minister of State for Tribal Development in the State Government of Maharashtra. So we would like to welcome him as well this evening for our program. And of course, we would like to welcome all the special guests for the program this evening. Oh God, playing the master strokes in life. India has been doing very well. In 2007, when India lost in the World Cup, there was a joke that was going around. And the joke was that a little girl was in the court because the parents were taking divorce. So the judge asked the girl, whom would you like to stay with? Mother, mummy, or daddy? Girl said, no, none. Said, why? You don't want to stay with mummy? Said, no, why? Mummy beats me. So then stay with daddy. No, daddy beats me. See, then if you don't want to stay with mummy because mummy beats you, don't want to stay with daddy because daddy beats you, then whom do you want to stay with? She said, the Indian cricket team. You know? So the judge asked, why? She said, they don't beat anyone. So when India lost in 2007, this was the joke that was going around that they don't beat anyone. And this time, and from 2011, God, now she won't even want to stay with. Because they're truly beating a few people. God. And then what to speak of West Indies and South Africa and Ireland and today Zimbabwe and now all the way into the quarterfinals. Are you excited? Sadhu ke samne aap sab shant ho gaye lagta hai. Excitement bante rahe. They're not even shouting that they're excited about the World Cup. I remember His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj, he was doing a program in the year 1996 in Borivali. And when he was in Borivali, it was the day when there was an Indo-Pak match. And we were expecting about 3,000 to 4,000 guests. We had cooked prasadam for about 4,000 people. 3,500 to 4,000 people. It was an Indo-Pak match. So Maharaj came for the lecture. He sat on the Vyasasana on the stage. And he looked into the audience. There was only ladies. And the only men present were us, brahmacharis, sitting in front of him. We were the few select people who were sitting there. And then Maharaj called one of us and asked, what happened? Where are the men? He said, Maharaj, Indo-Pak match. So then he gave a talk, only ladies were there. Then during the kirtan, he picked the harmonium and closed his eyes and started singing. And suddenly there was fireworks. So he opened his eyes to realize India had won. And suddenly 1,500 men joined. You know. And in our kirtan, we have dancing. So they were celebrating India's victory, not the holy name of Krishna. So I always say, India jeete ya hare, hamara to dhanda pura chalta hai. India jeetta hai to celebrate karne aata hai. Aur harta hai to santona ke liye aate. Prabhu ji kuch thoda sola. So our dhanda pani goes on well. And I remember in the year 2011 World Cup, I went to receive Radhanath Maharaj at the airport. He had come from Mayapur. And there was only 2 days for the World Cup final, India-Sri Lanka. And Radhanath Maharaj is from America. He was born an American Jew in a Jewish family. His earlier name was Richard Slavin. Now he took sannyas from Prabhupada. And he's His Holiness Radhanath Swami. So there was a television reporter. He was very excited to see an American Swami, an American sannyasi. So he came with his television camera and it was only me and Maharaj walking. So he came and asked me, Swamiji ko bolo ek interview dene cricket ke liye. Main bola, mere bhai Swamiji, America se wo baseball jante hain, cricket nahi jante wo. Bola, nahi nahi, bolo ashirwad de do India ko bas, wo bhi chalega. So I told, nahi nahi, Swamiji nahi denge, abhi thakke aaye hain. So we sat in the car, Maharaj sat in the front seat, I was sitting in the back seat. And this television crew with the camera, I can't remember which channel it was, is knocking at the windshield on Maharaj. So Maharaj opened the windshield and said, yes? He said, Swamiji, I like you to give an interview for the India's World Cup final and say some words of blessing to the Indian cricket team. So Maharaj said, okay. So my plan failed. And the television camera and everything there and said, Swamiji, say something for the Indian cricket team. What is your opinion? Who will win? Sri Lanka or India? Now, firstly, Maharaj doesn't know cricket. And he had been little updated with the news, but not more than that. So Maharaj said, actually, to tell you the truth, I'm from America. And the only cricket I know is an insect called cricket. And beyond that, the game is truly not known to me. But I'll tell you something, he said. I came to India way back in the year 1970, 71. And the people of India gave me so much affection, so much love, that I'm praying that India wins. And that guy was saying, thank you, Swamiji. My God. And to tell you the truth, it's not just he didn't know cricket. I absolutely don't know cricket. Can you believe that? I'm an Indian. Somehow sports was not my forte. So I didn't get into that. 1985, Benson Hedges tournament. The matches were coming early in the morning, 2, 2.30, 3 in the morning. And my father, who left his body 4-5 years back, he was such a die-hard fan of cricket. He would have a Diwali mein crackers ka budget for the whole year's cricket. India jeeta to ye budgeted crackers hoga. The only problem he had a son who was socially outcast. I had no interest in cricket, so he didn't have any company. So what he did is, he caught my poor mom, who was from the village. She was brought up in a village. And he gave her an orientation course on what cricket was meant to be. And taught her cricket fully. She got to know all the terms. And they used to get up in the morning, take a shower and keep 2 flasks of tea ready. So like gopis were cursing Brahma that, you know, our eyelids should not blink when we see Krishna. So just in order that Ailing should not bliss for one ball, they would keep all these flasks of tea ready. And then one morning my mother came up to me and she said, "Utho." I said, "Kyun?" She said, "You should see cricket." I said, "Should see? What do you mean should see? I'm not interested." She said, "No, no, no, you have to see." I said, "I can't." I must have been 6th or 7th standard, you know. And then she said, "This is completely being a social outcast. Log cheetu karenge tum pe. Cricket nahi dekhte tum." And I remember she slapped me to get up in the morning. I got a tight slap on my face to get up and watch cricket. And then I was in the center, on one side my father and one side my mother giving me Divya Gyan about cricket and about trying to understand cricket. And I couldn't understand then and I didn't understand today. It's just because it's just not my cup of herbal tea. I don't drink tea, so I must say herbal tea. I absolutely don't remember who won in that match, but I do remember the jhapad. It was quite a part, you know. Cricket, such a part of life. Such a part of life. Like Lord Vishnu pervades everywhere in his Sarva Vyapi. So cricket pervades every pore of this country called India. One guy here may not pick up the bat, but seeing there, tu mar, humse to hoga nahi, tum maro. You know, they will not pick up a ball, they will not pick up a bat, but they'll say, tum karo, you do. And they will keep cheering the players. My God. Our Braj Bihari Prabhu, who is also a brahmachari here, senior brahmachari, is, you know, MBA in international finance, gold medalist in international finance. And cricket was his life. There was not a single match at Wankhede or Brabourne Stadium that he missed. Reason, his father was in the highest position in Western Railways. They had a special stand booked for them. He would sit there in the front and watch all the matches. You know. And someone told him Hare Krishna temple, this, that. He came. He knew nothing about Hare Krishna. He walked into the temple and he saw in the altar. And when he saw Gaur Nitai, he thought, who are these two umpires saying sixer? Thinking, who are these two umpires raising their hands up saying, six, six? See that? In the game of life, whether an umpire gives that sixer or not, they need to say sixer. And when they give sixer and say, okay, blessed, your game is final. But I must tell you, such a part of life. So please excuse my ignorance of cricket. I had an orientation course with some people who knew cricket to just get the lingo. And I still will not be able to get it. I know I'll be confused. So I won't use too much. But if you do see me go a little off track into wrong terminology, please feel free to correct me. And how's that? See, I got it right. That much at least I have to know. I don't know much about cricket otherwise. But we all come to this Prerana festival truly to get knowledge, isn't it? We all come here to get knowledge. And we come here to get knowledge. And the world outside, everyone's getting knowledge. People are going to academic institutes, schools, top universities of the world. And I travel overseas a lot. I go to different universities in the United Kingdom, sometimes in Germany. And everyone's so obsessed with knowledge. Not wrong. Wonderful. Extremely wonderful that the world looks at knowledge. Isn't it? And sometimes so they're not good at that also. Even academic knowledge, they're not good. One teacher in the class is asking, in the school class, she's asking the children, ek ladke ko khada kiya. चांद पे पहला कदम किसने रखा बोल? तो बोला नील आर्मस्ट्रांग ने. बोला और दूसरा किसने रखा? बोला अरे ओके लंगड़ी खेलने गया था, दूसरा भी उसने तो रखा होगा ना, इवन द सेकेंड पुट दूसरा कौन रखेगा, लंब स्ट्रोक कौन रखेगा. देयरफॉर इवन इन एकेडमिक नॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स आई गॉट, समवन सेड टू बी समवन स्टूडेंट सेड गैलीलियो हैड अ ग्रेट माइंड, आइंस्टाइन हैड अ जीनियस माइंड, न्यूटन हैड एन एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी माइंड, Bill Gates has a brilliant mind, and we the students never mind. You know, this knowledge has two divisions, material and spiritual. Apara and para. Apara vidya is material knowledge, para vidya is spiritual knowledge, and we need both. We can't be on an extreme end. We can go on the extreme end on being academically oriented and make a great time having money, and we may miss playing the master strokes of life with spiritual knowledge. Or we may be on an extreme end getting into spiritual knowledge, learning how to play the master strokes in life, and forget to get the academic side of it and be a dunce in the world. Thus, a balance of the two. Apara vidya, which you get in your universities when you go to your universities, and paravidya, which when you come to this university, you get. This balance is a must in life. And what does aparavidya give you? Aparavidya gives you knowledge, great knowledge, and that material knowledge gives you a great lifestyle, isn't it? You can have the best brands. You can have Giorgio Armani, you can have Tommy Hilfiger. You can have the best brands to dress up with, the best cars to be driven in, the best homes to live in, the best places to visit for your vacations. Your lifestyle will be great because apara vidya pays you. Apara vidya, your academic knowledge pays you. And if you're a good Jew, you don't even need apara vidya. You don't even need a paravidya. Bill Gates, he decided to have the CEO for the Europe operations for Microsoft. So he called for candidates, and Bill Gates was present to interview. There were 5,000 candidates there. And when Bill Gates came, he addressed into the address system. He said, okay, now anyone here who does not know Java, you please go. Out of the 5,000, 2,000 left, there was one Mr. Patel. He thought, well, I don't know Java, but try karvama su mare chalaje. No problem. No problem. Then Bill Gates said, now anyone who does not have a management degree, please leave. So there were only 3,000 left anyways, 2,000 more left. And our Mr. Patel said, Who to tisri fail chu pan try karvama su vare che. No problem. Now there's only 1,000 left. Bill Gates said, now anyone who does not have experience of managing a project with at least 100 people, please leave. 500 people left, leaving behind only 500. And Mr. Patel said, I don't know if I manage myself, but try. Then Bill Gates said, now that 500 people left, only anyone who does not know Croatian and Serbian, please leave. 498 people left. There was only two. And one Mr. Patel thought, I don't know nothing but Gujarati. But try karvama su che. Vandu nathi ne. So then two people left in the hall, everyone's gone, and Bill Gates looked at them, and he doesn't know any Croatian or Serbian. He said, now that you claim that you know Serbian and Croatian, I want to see you talk. So Mr. Patel asked the other guy, kem cho? And the other guy said, ekdam majama. I'll tell you. Oh my God, I must tell you something. To make a living, you don't need much apara vidya. You just need some substance up here. And you will make it great there. So yes, indeed, apara vidya or material knowledge gives us a great lifestyle. But para vidya or spiritual knowledge gives us a great life. And there's a difference between lifestyle and life. You may be dressed in a Tommy Hilfiger and may be a nervous, miserable wreck. A wreck. Dressed in the best brands, being driven in a Lamborghini and a wreck. Is that what knowledge is meant to do to us? Ladies and gentlemen, material knowledge provides us with money, which gives us a great lifestyle, but it can do nothing to your inner systems. To make a life, therefore, to live a life of contentment, control, satisfaction, one needs spiritual knowledge. Thus, material knowledge is about quantity. And people focus so much on quantity, isn't it? The world outside focuses on quantity. People want to be rich. There are some people who have a lot of money. And there are some who are rich. Because money doesn't make richness. Some people are just so poor, absolutely so poor, that all they have is money. You can imagine. All they have is money. And I'm wondering, we are so overwhelmed by quantity. How many of you have an iPhone 6? God! Which yuga am I sitting in? Looks like I'm sitting in Satya Yuga. How many of you have a Samsung? How many of you have Samsung with 128 GB storage on the phone? Quantity matters so much to us. Storage space badao phone pe. Are kya duniya ka number rakhega kya usme? Sab duniya bhar ka number aayega usme. Storage space badao uska phone ka. You know, so overwhelmed by quantity. But quality of life suffers very badly in this Kali Yuga. People are stressed, depressed, yet well-dressed. You know, stressed and depressed, yet well-dressed. So spiritual knowledge looks at quality, material knowledge looks at quantity, and we need a balance of both. The third is, material knowledge simply makes you prove to the world ki maine kuch kar dikhaya hai. Ab kya samajhte hain? Sure. I couldn't go to the Indian cricket team. Theek hai. Lekin gali mein to khelta hi hai hum. Try to prove to the world. Hai na? दुनिया को दिखाना चाहते हैं हम. फर्स्ट क्यों आना चाहते हो? अरे फर्स्ट आओ ना. कम फर्स्ट बाय योर मेरिट. दुनिया को दिखाने के लिए फर्स्ट मत आओ. यू वांट टू गेट अ ग्रेट जॉब ना, गेट अ ग्रेट जॉब. हु इज स्टॉपिंग यू? डोंट डू इट टू प्रूव टू द वर्ल्ड दैट यू आर ग्रेट. योर ग्रेटनेस विल बी सीन बाय द वर्ल्ड. यू डोंट हैव टू प्रूव टू द वर्ल्ड दैट यू आर ग्रेट. द प्रॉब्लम इज एवरी वन इज ओवरवेल्म्ड बाय दिस थिंग दैट आई वांट टू प्रूव दैट आई एम द बेस्ट. यू डोंट प्रूव बाय टेलिंग एंड शोइंग ऑफ. यू प्रूव बाय डूइंग थिंग्स इन एन एक्सलेंट वे. When you live by excellence, you automatically prove to the world. You know, you don't have to do anything separately to prove to the world that I've done something and I'm great. Hai na? Impress karna chahte hain sabko. Valentine Day pe. Bhaade ke gaadi mein jaate hain. Thank God, juta to khud ka hai. College students kya impress karenge? One guy was asking another guy, तेरे फोन में क्या क्या है बोल? तो बोला मेरे फोन में कैमरा है, मेरे फोन में मेमोरी कार्ड है, मेरे फोन में वोडाफोन का सिम है, मेरे फोन में ये है, इतना कॉन्टैक्ट हुआ, तेरे पास क्या है? वो बोला मेरे फोन में बैलेंस है. स्टूडेंट्स का तो बैलेंस भी जीरो होता है. एंड देयरफॉर इट्स नॉट अबाउट प्रूविंग टू द वर्ल्ड. Material knowledge makes us prove and spiritual knowledge makes us improve. Don't try to prove. Try to improve, and when you improve, automatically proof comes to the world. If you improve, duniya ko dikhta nahi hai kya? Andhe hain kya log duniya mein? People all can see very clearly. Try to improve in your life, and that was the difference between Karna and Arjuna. Karna was trying to prove. Arjuna was trying to improve. When you try to prove, there is pratiyogita. When you try to improve, there is pratiyogita with yourself. दूसरों के साथ प्रतियोगिता मत कीजिए, खुद के साथ प्रतियोगिता कीजिए और खुद के साथ प्रतियोगिता होकर इंप्रूव करोगे ना तो क्रिकेट की प्रतियोगिता में जाओगे तो भी एक्सेल करोगे, अलग से प्रूव करने का जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगा. एज अ थर्ड एस्पेक्ट ऑफ मटेरियल एंड स्पिरिचुअल, द फोर्थ एस्पेक्ट ऑफ मटेरियल नॉलेज इज इट जस्ट मेक्स यू गो थ्रू लाइफ. इट जस्ट मेक्स यू गो थ्रू लाइफ. You just go through it. All the different stages of life. First poopsie, then Pepsi, and then Hari Ram. I know many of you are stuck at the third stage of your going through life, but one guy is saying, what is better, 1 liter of milk or 1 glass of unadulterated vodka? Which is more powerful? So the guy said, obviously 1 glass of vodka. Said, how? Said, you drink 1 liter of milk and you bang the wall. Does the wall move? And you take 1 glass of vodka, you don't do anything, it starts moving. Oh my God. Life today has become material knowledge, just takes you, goes, makes you go through life, but spiritual knowledge makes you grow through life. Don't go through, grow through life. And in growing through life, like a larva in a cocoon, there is pain. In going through, there is no pain. Galat karne mein koi kasht nahi hai. If you have to do wrong, you're not going to have to do anything. You don't have to go through pain. Later, as a reaction, you'll have to go through pain. But otherwise, to have a great time and a gala time and go around partying and socializing, it's not a big deal. You don't have to go through any pain. But if you want to improve and grow in your life, coming out of the cocoon of your lethargy, coming out of the cocoon of your laziness, coming out of the cocoon of your complacency, it's painful to work hard, to succeed. But we grow as a beautiful butterfly. And therefore, don't just go through, grow through. That is spiritual knowledge. And conclusively, material knowledge is all about information. You know? There is a term called incarnation diarrhea now. खाने के बाद जैसा बहुत सारा क्या होता है, दस्त लगती है. So when you have too much knowledge, they say it's an information diarrhea. New term coined now, new phrase coined in the world. है ना? Overwhelmed by information. Once Aurangzeb told all his soldiers, Mughal soldiers, अरे जाओ शिवाजी को ढूंढ के लाओ. The Mughal soldier said, sab sab ghoomke thak gaye, hum Mughal hai, Google nahi. Dhundne ke liye Shivaji ko. Kya Shivaji search dal ke kya Google mein dhundega kya usko Shivaji ko? In an age which is so overwhelmed by information, the problem is we forget transformation. So material knowledge is about information, but spiritual knowledge of Paravidya gives us transformation, changes us. How many of you, be honest, in front of God, would like to deal with your bad habits, external or internal, whichever? Good. And does academic knowledge, material knowledge help? It doesn't. How many of you would like to change your attitudes to being positive attitudes despite failure? And does material knowledge help? No. How many of you would like to change your behavioral patterns and character? And does material knowledge help? I have seen material knowledge to make people arrogant, to make people impudent, to make people have audacity and an air around them. The higher they go up, they think that there's something. I'm not talking of everyone. I'm not generalizing. But I see that becomes the characteristics of such knowledge. Knowledge is meant to breed humility. Gyan ke saath namrata aani chahiye. Victory should bring humility. And in that Titanic talk, I had said, Vijay ke saath saath hona chahiye vinay. Agar Vijay ke saath vinay nahi hai, to kya paya hai jindagi mein humne? Gentlemen, please join me to summarize the 5 differences between material and spiritual knowledge. Number 1, material gives you a lifestyle and spiritual gives you a life. Number 2, Material knowledge is about quantity and spiritual is about quality. And number three, material gives you prove and spiritual improve. And number four, material makes you just go through life and spiritual helps you grow through life. And number five, information and transformation. At our Prerana festival, we come for the second kind, to change our value systems, to change our attitudes, to change our belief systems in a way that our life, our behavior, our words, our academic courses, our work, everything will be positively reformed and changed. And what is the best way to speak? Take what is the frame of reference of everyone else. When Titanic 3D movie came, they asked me to speak on Titanic because sab usme latka atka hai sabka mind. So we chose Titanic 2 years back. And now since the World Cup is going on, we decided we will do cricket. Take small steps, baby steps towards change, but change. One father was asking his son, beta, 9 into 8 is how much? He said, 22. So the father gave him a chocolate. The next day father asked, beta, how much is 9 into 8? He said, 32. Father gave him a chocolate. The neighbor said, sir, what are you doing? He's giving a wrong answer. How can you do this? He said, look, he may be giving a wrong answer, but yesterday he was saying 22, today he's saying 32, tomorrow he'll say 42. When he reaches 72, I'll say, don't go ahead, beta, now stay here. Ladies and gentlemen, change in life comes with small steps. We may be at 22 and our journey is from 22 to 72 in a habit that we want to deal with. We are at 22, we want to reach 72 and you can't take a leap of 50. Take a baby step of change. A small step of change. One little step from 22 to 22.25. That is also a step ahead of change. And we will definitely change if we come to change our value systems by paravidya or spiritual knowledge. One guy who used to come for my Gita classes, he used to smoke 63 cigarettes a day. Can you believe that? 63 cigarettes a day. And not surprising, he was into FNOs, futures and options. Always anxious and stressed. 62 to 63 cigarettes a day. That is the minimum. That is like 16 rounds minimum. Then above that, he would do more. Above that, he would. That is extra rounds. Extra mala. So one day he comes up to me and says, Prabhuji, I want to stop smoking. I said, absolutely not. Kya bol raha hai smoking band karna hai? Bilkul nahi. Continue smoking. He was completely flabbergasted hearing my response. Not from me at least. I said, please continue smoking 62 daily. You're doing 63, no? Do 62 daily. That leap of 50 is not possible for you, no? 63 to 0, 63 to 62 hoga. Kyun nahi hoga? Ek-ek karke, aaj ye gentleman 45 pe aa gaya hai 3 saal mein. Aayega, zero pe bhi aayega. Char prerana baad. 4 years later. And therefore, I always feel we need to take small steps to change. And today's frame of reference for us to discuss is change through playing the master strokes in life. You know? And what are those master strokes? India mein to aisa amazing jugadu log hai na? हर चीज में जुगाड़ करते हैं. क्रिकेट खेलने में भी जुगाड़ होता है उनका, है ना? क्रिकेट खेलने में भी जुगाड़ होता है और हर चीज में जुगाड़ होता है. दे आर जुगाडूज इन एवरीथिंग. दे विल लॉक देयर चप्पल्स आल्सो. एकदम इंडिजिनियस इन्वेंशंस होता है. कुकिंग करने में गैस खत्म हो गया तो दे नो हाउ टू कुक व्हेन द गैस गेट्स ओवर, यू नो. एंड दिस इज अ बैचलर इन द हॉस्टल कुकिंग रोटी विद बियर बॉटल. जब उसको बेलन नहीं मिला ना. He's moving with Balan. And this guy wants to hear music, so he's tucked his laptop in the lungi and is hearing sound while frying pakodas. You can imagine. That's our jugadu.com. You know. And this is incredible office. Mercedes to afford kar nahi sakta. तो ऑफिस कोई बना दिया और वैसा बैठ गया उसमें, यू नो माय गॉड लॉट ऑफ जुगाड़ दे डू एंड दिस वन द नेशनल अवार्ड, यू नो नेशनल अवार्ड फॉर जुगाड़ एंड लुक एट दैट गाय सो पीसफुली सिटिंग इनसाइड. वो बच्चे को भी टेंशन नहीं है कि कुछ होगा मेरे साथ. ओ माय गॉड एंड दिस तो व्हाट कैन वी से गॉड, देयर इज अ ट्रेन कोच ऑन अ ट्रक, दैट्स कॉल्ड जुगाड़. But in India, oh, that's even from the moon they start vada pav. When Neil Armstrong goes to start a vada pav stall on the moon, you know. And then, this is proper desi jugad when you want to play cricket. I'm sure all of you have played like that. Eat rakke, kitne log khele cricket, bolo, eat rakke. Haan? Oh, eat ke do se andar se gaya to clean bolt. Hai ki nahi? और अगर गटर में गिरा जाके तो नहीं जी चौका. और अगर आंटी का काश टूटा तो वेल क्रिकेट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ. दिस इवनिंग वी हैव गैदर्ड टू लर्न अ फ्यू लेसन्स इन द नेक्स्ट 45 मिनट्स टू एन आवर. आई ऑलवेज टेक अबाउट 30 मिनट्स टू वार्म अप. More than myself, you need that warm-up before I start. And therefore, today we want to learn. I have listed 8 lessons. I don't know if I can finish all 8. But whatever we finish, to our credit. And therefore, let us begin learning master strokes in this game of life. Cricket is about balls and bats. A bowler and a batsman. Variety of bowlers. I don't even know the names. I told you, I'm ignorant in cricket. I truly don't know much about cricket. But what I'm told is the worst is a googly. That's what I'm told. I tried googling googly. And I was told when a leg spinner just changes the direction of the ball a little bit, he puts. That's all I know. I truly don't know much cricket. So, thoda sa tilt karke dalta hai na. वो जो बैट्समैन है वो एक्सपेक्ट कर रहा है कि बॉल ऐसा आएगा, और जब गूगली पड़ता है तो उसके बैट को लग के गया साइड से, आउटस्विंग बोलते हैं नहीं उसको, आउटस्विंग होकर गया कॉट, द विकेट कीपर कैचेस आउट. मास्टर स्ट्रोक्स इन लाइफ. जिंदगी में बहुत बॉल पड़ रही है नहीं, लाइफ बहुत बॉलिंग करती है नहीं, लाइफ का गूगली क्या है मालूम है, आपके वाइवा में वो एग्जामिनर ऐसा क्वेश्चन पूछता है जो संसार में किसी को मालूम नहीं है, वो गूगली है. और रिजल्ट क्या है मालूम है, डक. Ladies and gentlemen, we have to learn to bat properly in this game of life called cricket. And therefore, lesson one from the game of cricket is any good batsman, any good cricketer, any good cricket player will first assess the ground, the pitch, will assess the strengths, the weaknesses, the opportunities and the threats. It's called a SWOT analysis. SWOT analysis means know what your strengths are, know what your weaknesses are, W, know what are the opportunities to hit, and know what are the threats. A leg spinner, an expert leg spinner. Every good batsman will first go and assess the situation to get everything cleared. Once that assessment is there and things are there, first get adapted to the ground as if it's your home ground. In the home ground, you can hit well. But if it's not your home ground, it's not as easy. The terrain is different. The country is different. People who are cheering are different. The umpire is not in your favor because he's a third umpire, not of any country. God, I'll tell you something. There is a great need for assessment because it's not your place. One kid mein khelenge na, are maro yaar, Bombay hai. Udhar Melbourne mein jayenge na,
देखना पड़ता है सब कुछ बराबर क्या है. फर्स्ट असेसिंग द रियलिटीज ऑफ द पिच, हुम आर यू प्लेइंग अगेंस्ट, हु इज द टीम, हु आर द फास्ट बोलर्स, हु आर द लेग स्पिनर्स, ऑल ऑफ दैट स्टफ. Assessment of situations of the game, you know, without which batting can be a little haphazard. We are all playing a game of life. Assess your opponent first. Till the time you do not know your opponent's strengths and weaknesses and your own strengths and weaknesses, there is a problem. जिंदगी में हम जब खेल रहे हैं, जिंदगी का द गेम ऑफ लाइफ, वी नीड टू ट्रूली असेस हु इज आवर ओपोनेंट. आई एम आस्किंग यू अ क्वेश्चन, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर विथ मी नाउ इन द टॉक? ओके गुड. हाउ मेनी ऑफ योर माइंड्स आर आउटसाइड दिस हॉल? बैठे बैठे ऐसे ही जुप, और फिर कुछ तो हा 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 हुआ, ओ बैक. You know, do you know something? In the game of life, you're playing a cricket match against an entity called the mind. Aur is entity ke saath agar aap jeet gaye to duniya ki koi shakti aapko rok nahi sakti. No one on planet Earth can stop you from accomplishing and achieving what you want if you can bat against the googlies that the mind bowls at you. How many of you have experienced that the mind bowls googlies? Good. When it comes to exercising and jogging, how many of you know that the mind bowls googlies? Majja. Soja. Soja. Wo aapko out karna chahta hai. आपका मन आपके गेम में आपको आउट करना चाहता है ताकि आप चौका छक्का लगा के सक्सेसफुल नहीं हो. एक ही व्यक्ति है रोकने वाला आपको आपके यश में, वो है ये फास्ट बॉलर, मन, द माइंड. सो एक्टिव ना, सोता है तो भी छोड़ता नहीं है. बॉडी इज इनएक्टिव, उसका बॉलिंग चल रहा है, बैट्समैन थक गया है, वही तो बंद कर अभी. बैट्समैन ने बैट नीचे रख दिया है तब भी इसका बॉल चल रहा है. बोल रहा उठने के बाद वो मारेगा, वो आए उसको मुझे बोल्ड करना है, बस क्लीन बोल्ड कॉन्स्टेंटली. सपना आता है सपना. वन लेडी, एक पत्नी अपनी पति से पूछ रही है, पति बोलता है पत्नी को, 4 बजे उठाता है पत्नी को, बोला मुझे एक सपना आया. बोला क्या आया सपने में? बोला एक बहुत सुंदर आई, सुंदर लड़की आई. सो शी सेड मैं थी ना? बोला बिल्कुल नहीं. सो देन द लेडी सेड अकेली आई होगी नहीं वो? पति साहब बराबर, तुझे कैसे मालूम? बोला उसका पति मेरे सपने में आया था. हर हस्बैंड केम इन माई ड्रीम. ये मन, आई यूज टू गो टू राधा रमन टेम्पल इन वृंदावन, एंड देर इन द राधा रमन टेम्पल आई वाज टू हियर वन डिवोटी सिंग दिस सॉन्ग. ये मन बड़ा पागल है, कैसे तेरा भजन करूं, जितना इसे समझाऊं उतना ही मचलता है. समझाया आपने आपके मन को? शांत बैठता है वो, बॉलिंग बंद करता है वो, वो तो बॉल पे बॉल डाला जाता है आपको आउट करने के लिए, ताकि आपने जो प्रण लिया है, द वर्ड दैट यू हैव गिवन टू गॉड, टू योर फैमिली, इन योर लाइफ, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू कीप योर वाउज, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू कीप योर रिजॉल्व. दैट इज द जॉब ऑफ दिस ओपोनेंट टीम ऑफ योर्स, द माइंड एंड माइन ऑफ कोर्स. द माइंड, माय गॉड, आई वांट टू टेल ऑल ऑफ यू, assess this opponent who's very strong, one of the best bowlers in the history of cricket is the mind. aisa googly dalta hai ki kuch nahi kar sakte aap log. How many of you have had a conflict within? Good, thank you. How many of you have had a conflict? Mandir jaye ki nahi aaj prerana ke liye? Thank you, gentlemen. Raise your hands up. Don't worry. Don't worry. Your mind is bowling. Don't worry. है ना? आपके मन ने तो बोला ही होगा ना? अरे किधर वो टकलों के पास मंदिर में जा रहा है तू? हाँ? क्या है वो मंदिर में क्या रखा हुआ है? हाँ? वो गूगल ही डालता है? मत जा. फिर दूसरा दोस्त बोलता है अरे तू चल उधर. उधर श्रद्धा है, भक्ति है, पूजा है, आराधना है, सब है उधर. तू चल बस. हरे कृष्णा. और फिर हाँ 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 उधर प्रेरणा भी है. हरे कृष्णा. What Google is by the mind will stop you from doing what you want. How many of you have trouble in studying? Raise your hands as students. My God. And you come here, you hear all of these things. Don't get distracted by WhatsApp. Don't get distracted by internet pornography. Don't get distracted by Twitter. Don't get distracted by Facebook. Study. Don't get distracted by birds to do bird watching. Study. All these distractions, इधर आके कुछ उपदेश देते हैं कुछ लोग, साधु लोग आपको, उस पे बाद भी फेल होता है वो. So one father was telling his son, देख देख तेरे क्लास में वो लूसी है ना, लूसी देख देख फर्स्ट आई है वो, और तू नालायक फेल हो गया. वो बोला देख देख के ही फेल हो गया मैं उसको. देख देख के ही तो फेल हुआ मैं उसको. I'll tell you something. My God, the mind. आपको जब बोला जाए उधर मत देख, मन गूगली डालता है, सुन मत उसका. तू उसका तो कुछ हुआ नहीं, तेरा भी रोक रहा है. सुनो मत इसका. इन साधुओं का, डिवोटी लोगों का सुनो मत. मन गूगली डालता है. Why? Because the mind doesn't want you to win the game of life. How many of you wanted to wake up early in the morning? Raise your hands. Only wanted, I asked. Wanted to wake up early in the morning. And how many of you have done something called as setting an alarm clock? Nana? Char was tasa laula, char. Kitti himmate paata cha, madhe char cha alarm laula tani. अहो छत्रपती शिवाजी महाराजांकडे एवढी हिंमत नव्हती एवढी आमच्या मुलांकडे. चार वाजताचा अलार्म लावतात ते. फोर ओ क्लॉक. अँड देन आफ्टर सेटिंग द अलार्म क्लॉक एट फोर, दॅट्स अन अलार्म. यू वॉन्ट इट ऑर नॉट इट रिंग्स. अँड वेन इट रिंग्स द माइंड पुट्स इट्स फर्स्ट गुगली. And your intelligence tells your mind, अरे exam दो दिन पे है, पढ़ाई नहीं हुआ है, किताब जिस दिन खरीदा था अभी तो खुशबू वैसा ही है, खोला ही नहीं है, खोला ही नहीं अभी तक. What are you doing? What does the mind do? By putting the googly makes you clean bold when you do the first snooze. You are out. You are out. If you snooze, you are out. And then the second snooze. And the third snooze. Finish. Turn the alarm off. Mere se nahi hoga. Ye bowler bahut powerful hai. Maine to apna bat hi niche rakh diya hai. I want to say something. I used to do this earlier, you know. I would love to. I still sometimes do it. I know it's bad, but I do it. Many times I sleep very late in the night. I have a lifestyle, a lot of programs, Bombay, everything starts late. You don't get enough sleep in the night many times. And if you sleep at 1 o'clock in the night, and if you have to wake up at 4 for Mangalarti, it's not easy. Not easy at all. And I've slept, like in the last week, I've slept like 1:30, 1:45 to 2 because of coming back from somewhere at that time. And when the alarm rings, no, it's not easy, ladies and gentlemen. आसान नहीं है वो अलार्म से उठना तुरंत. बहुत कठिन होता है उठना तुरंत बिना स्नूज किए. तो मैं कभी कभी क्या करता हूँ मालूम है, मैं ना
चार बजे उठना होता है, पांच बजे का मंगल आरती है, तो 4:45 का अलार्म लगाता हूं, 3 स्नूज करके, केवल एक मेंटल फीलिंग के लिए कि 15 मिनट ज्यादा सोया. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव डन इट, रेज योर हैंड्स ऑनेस्टली. माय गॉड, लुक एट दैट, आई थॉट आई एम दी ओनली वन. Sleeps like a common strategy all over the place, just to get that mental feel ki 3 snooze mein 15 minutes. Arey, neend khol ke disturb ho gaya, phaltu mein 15 minute. I want to say one thing, just one, and probably this will change the direction of your life. You know something? When you snooze the alarm, what happens? You decide to give in to the mind's bowl. Decide to give in to the mind's ball. And this is how your morning begins, by giving in to the mind. सवेरे की शुरुआत होती है इस बॉलर से क्लीन बोल्ड होके, आगे क्या मैच जीतेंगे. ये तो दिन की शुरुआत है, by giving in. And it's no problem giving in. Sleeping 5 minutes extra is no problem. The problem is you develop the attitude of giving in. You tell yourself that what I decided last night is not as important. What is important is what the mind says. Because we listen. When we listen to our mind, that means what we decided is not as important as what the mind is telling us at this point of time. I'll tell you something, my humble advice. Because it's not just about getting up in the morning, it's about every aspect of life. Whether it's your work, if you're working, whether it's your study, if you're studying, whether it's your chanting, if you're a devotee of Krishna, whatever we do. The problem is, it's not about one thing. Sabere ho gaya na, it reflects in every area of life. Isliye main kehta hu, agar 4 baje nahi uthna malum hai na, apne se nahi hota, 4:20 ka alarm lagao, lekin 4:20 ko utho. Don't allow that snooze. Because every time you allow that snooze, you are allowing this opponent to google you and make you clean bold. Are you all with me? Are you ready for the second master stroke? The first master stroke is assess your opponent and the pitch. And we have very well assessed our opponent, the mind. Aisa opponent hai ki bar bar out karta rehta hai, nahi? And therefore the second aspect is, practice is the key. There is no substitute to practice in any sport, including cricket. Praveen Amreji is here. Ask him. Abhay Chaitanya Prabhu is here. You were also for playing for Ranji Trophy, right? And do you know that he is the mentor of Ajinkya Rahane? Abhay Chaitanya Prabhu is the mentor of Ajinkya Rahane. Huh? Say it again. Okay. Yes, great. cricket. You know, and therefore, they know well how much time goes into practice. How much time goes into practice to be able to, when the bowler throws the ball, jab tak practice nahi kiya hai na, wo ball aayega to kaise marega? Semester bhar padhai nahi kiya aur pass hona hai. Professor googly dalta hai, nahi? और आपको छक्का मारना है, कैसे छक्का मारेंगे? Without study, without practice, even in our chanting Hare Krishna, devotional service to Krishna, we need practice. And we have one brahmachari, keeps chanting all day, for a long time he keeps chanting. So one day we asked him, we chant 16 rounds of Hare Krishna mantra, you are chanting morning 2:30 onward till 5, then fixed to over 8, then through the day, how much you are chanting? He said, मैं क्रिकेट खेलता हूं प्रभु जी, मेरे माइंड के अगेंस्ट मैं क्रिकेट खेलता हूं, और ये जो बाकी सब मैं खेलता हूं ना, ये एक्स्ट्रा प्रैक्टिस है, ताकि 2 घंटा जब मंदिर में सवेरे बैठूंगा तो बराबर छक्का चौका लगेगा. नहीं तो कैसे लगेगा छक्का चौका मंदिर में? प्रैक्टिस इज द की. टाइगर वुड्स वाज आस्क्ड, यू नो टाइगर वुड्स द गोल्फ प्लेयर, ही वाज आस्क्ड, सर व्हाट इज द सीक्रेट टू योर सक्सेस? ही सेड 3 वर्ड्स, ओनली 3 वर्ड्स, प्रैक्टिस प्रैक्टिस प्रैक्टिस. 3 वर्ड बोला बस, प्रैक्टिस प्रैक्टिस प्रैक्टिस, एंड देयर इज नथिंग. एंड इन आवर टेम्पल, इन द इस्कॉन सोसाइटी, बेस्ड ऑन आवर शास्त्रास, वी कॉल इट साधना.
Practice in Sanskrit is called sadhana. Whether it's your bhakti, whether it's cricket, whether it's academics, whether it's work, if you don't do sadhana, you cannot be victorious. Victory requires practice. Victory requires sadhana. Victory requires dedication. Victory requires commitment. And people do so much practice. You know, tremendous amount of practice. To succeed without practice, नहीं जमेगा. मन के गूगली को मारना है ना सवेरे उठने के लिए, एक बॉल में नहीं होगा. हर रोज प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा. डोंट एक्सपेक्ट. अभी पेपटॉक सुना है कल 4 बजे. आपको क्या लगता है आपका ओपोनेंट सुनेगा आपका? मैं देखूंगा आपको ऑनलाइन व्हाट्सएप पे कब शुरू किया आपने. लास्ट सीन एट. ओ माय गॉड, व्हाट अ क्रूशियल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ लाइफ इज प्रैक्टिस. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, डोंट वरी. इन अ सिंगल ओवर व्हेन द बॉलर इज बॉलिंग एट द बैट्समैन, पहला बॉल डाला वेस्ट गया, कुछ नहीं आया उसमें. सेकेंड डाला वेस्ट गया, कुछ नहीं आया. तीसरा गया वेस्ट हुआ, कुछ नहीं आया. लगे रहो, बैट पकड़े रहो, छोड़ो मत. 4-5 दिन में नतीजा नहीं आता. ऐसा नहीं होता कि आज भर्ती और कल चक्रवर्ती. आज तक लाइफ में कोई भर्ती होके तुरंत चक्रवर्ती नहीं हुआ है. भर्ती और चक्रवर्ती के बीच में पापड़ बेलने पड़ते हैं प्रैक्टिस और साधना के. बहुत बड़े बड़े सचिन तेंदुलकर, अजिंक्य रहाणे, अमरेजी और क्या क्या नाम हमने सुने, कोई एक रात में नहीं बने ये लोग. पापड़ बेले इन्होंने मेहनत के. इन वॉट एवर एरिया ऑफ लाइफ दे आर वॉन्टिंग टू सक्सीड, दे हैव पुट इन ट्रिमेंडस अमाउंट ऑफ हार्ड वर्क टू प्रैक्टिस, टू बी एबल टू हिट दैट 1 sixer, टू बी एबल टू हिट दैट 1 4, टू बी एबल टू टेक दैट 1 catch. How much practice is needed? And then you have shoulder tears, you have meniscal tears, you have Jones fractures. I was never into sports, and all my injuries that I have in the last 1 year are sports injuries. I got both meniscus torn and got operated by Dr. Pardiwala on that. Just 5 months back, I got a Jones fracture. So my orthopedic surgeon is asking me, Prabhu ji, aap kahan football khelte, kaisa toda ye? And now I have a tear in my left shoulder with a cyst developed, which only happens to bowlers and basketballers. और अभी right में भी गड़बड़ निकला है. तो हमारा डॉक्टर बोलता है कि कौन है आप? खेलते तो है नहीं, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम सब स्पोर्ट्स वालों का है आपका. Honestly, they are shocked. How did you get this? What to do? एक बॉल नहीं हुआ, ठीक है. ओवर में दूसरा बॉल नहीं हुआ, ठीक है. बल्ला पकड़े रहो, मारने दो मन को बॉल. एक दिन नहीं उठेंगे, ठीक है. एक बॉल गया, दूसरे दिन नहीं उठेंगे, ठीक है. दूसरा बॉल गया, तीसरे दिन नहीं उठेंगे, ठीक है. तीसरा बॉल गया, यहां आके ये सुनते रहो, ओवर के लास्ट बॉल में छक्का लगेगा जी. छक्का लगेगा और ओवर की कसर निकल जाएगी एक बॉल में. वेट फॉर दैट वन बॉल, वेट फॉर दैट वन बॉल वेर यू आर स्ट्रॉन्गर देन योर ओपोनेंट. टिल द टाइम द ओपोनेंट इज स्ट्रॉन्गर देन यू, नहीं हो रहा है, मैं छोड़ के जा रहा हूं, नहीं होगा मेरे से. वेट फॉर दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी वेन यू बिकम स्ट्रॉन्गर देन दैट ओपोनेंट. एंड इज दैट इजी? To become stronger than your mind? Are we idiots to come to the temple? Are we nuts to chant Hare Krishna? Are we foolish to offer a prayer to the Lord? क्योंकि मन को strong कौन क्या करेगा आपका? गोली? कौन सा गोली खा के आप मन को strong करेंगे आप? How will you defeat your mind? Unless you come to a spiritual path to get that strength, so that when that alarm rings, you will not snooze. So that when the temptation to type that URL in the web search of your internet browser comes, you will not type. Aasan thodi hai. Practice lagta hai. Sadhana lagti hai. Yehi to jindagi hai.
life is not meant to just live like that. The purpose of life is a life of purpose. Live a life of purpose. When you live a life of purpose, the social drama of gossip and criticism won't matter to you. Duniya kuch kuch bolti rahegi. When you're living for a purpose, kuch nahi farak padega duniya kya bolti. Bolne do unko jo bolna hai. Doesn't matter. You know? Because you're driven by a purpose. You will only crib about things happening when you don't have a purpose to live. You will crib that my parents don't give me a brand, my parents don't give me money for an iPhone. Or you will crib that, you know, she broke my heart. Or you'll crib that this happened, that happened. Cribbing will go on only when you live a life without purpose. Sadhana karni chahiye. Apne purpose ke liye sadhana karni chahiye. Dhundo apne purpose ko. ये जिंदगी में क्या टाइम वेस्ट करने आया है क्या अपने मन के अगेंस्ट? तो फॉर्ट बॉलर बोल कर रहा है, बॉलिंग अगेन एंड अगेन, थ्रोइंग गूगलीज एंड वेजेस, व्हाट कैन आई डू, व्हाट कैन आई डू, आई एम हेल्पलेस, नहीं होता मेरे से. इज दिस व्हाट वी केम टू दिस वर्ल्ड फॉर? वी केम टू दिस वर्ल्ड टू सीक आवर पर्पस. एंड व्हेन वी फाइंड दैट पर्पस, वी विल बी कंज्यूम्ड बाय दैट पर्पस. आवर हेल्थ, आवर पुअरनेस, आवर क्रिटिसिज्म पीपल डू अगेंस्ट अस विल बी नो वैल्यू टू अस बिकॉज वी आर कंज्यूम्ड बाय अ पर्पस. And it's true with a lot of people. Look for that purpose. Your spiritual purpose. Yes, you have your academic purpose, which is to get your degrees, earn money, get married, settle, have children. That everyone does. And you should do. No problem. But find your spiritual purpose to serve. Duniya mein aaya Ram, gaya Ram. Kya hai? Is there nothing you can do for others? Life is like a game of tennis. It begins with service. And ends with love all. You know, we should have service and we should have love all. And we can only love all when we have service towards the Lord. Don't serve the Lord, to love all is difficult, Baba. We have to go beyond sects. We have to go beyond boundaries. To serve, to love, to help. Find your purpose. Kamao paisa. Excel in your life. But don't earn to just improve your brands. Earn so you can serve. Earn so you can contribute. Don't just have passion. Have compassion. Because when we are driven by compassion, then sky is the limit to earn. If you have no compassion, utna kama ke karega kya? 10 kapda pehnega kya? Kya iPhone ka garland pehnega? What will you do?
Excited about it.
Oh my God. And therefore the second master stroke of life is practice. If you want to conquer this element called the mind, jitaatmanah prashantasya paramatma samahitah. The sixth chapter of the Gita tells us how the mind is so difficult to control. We're bowling up balls after balls. We need abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena chagrihyate. We need abhyas, sadhana, practice, without which to deal with the mind is an impossibility. Are you ready for the third master stroke? You remember the first one, yaad hai na? Assess your opponent. Second, practice, sadhana. And even if you assess your opponent, and no matter how much you practice, it doesn't matter. Because there will always be situations where there are people and situations beyond your control. There is a concept called sledging in cricket. And sledging is low class. It is low class. It is cheap. Where the opponent team comes and gives gali to the batsman. Gali. They try to distract them from and take their focus away. Gali de de ke focus nikalte. One thing that Sachin Tendulkar is known for is to remain cool. One thing that Sachin is adored for in the history of cricket is sledging hasn't bothered him. When people call names, people give gali and people do all kinds of stuff, this man is cool. Are you cool? When people do sledging against you in the game of life,
are you cool or you lose your cool? One Gujarati lady. She asked her husband, "Apde Diwali ma, Dimali ma, su gift lao so tame mara paate. I don't know Gujarati. What will you get for me?" So he said, "Kutri." He said, "Kutri." So this lady got so upset, said, "Tari ma kutri, taro baap kutro, taro bhai kutro, tari family kutri." And then the husband said, "Ari bavri, bakudi." The husband spat out the gutka and said, "Q3, Audi, Audi, Q3, Baba." So when you put mawa and gutka in the mouth, then Q3 sounds kutri, kutri. There will always be people who are out of control. Can you stop a guy from criticizing you? Can you start an opponent team from sledging? कुछ नहीं कर सकते. It's called things which are out of our control. People are out of our control sometimes. One lady had a fight with the husband. और झगड़ा हो गया पति पत्नी में, तो उसने अपनी माँ को फोन किया, "मम्मी मम्मी, मैं नहीं रह सकती इधर, ये बहुत हो गया, मैं झगड़ा हो गया, अभी मैं 2 हफ्ते के लिए आपके पास आ रही हूं मैं मम्मी." तो उसकी माँ बोली, "नहीं नहीं बेटा, उसको उसके कर्मों का फल भुगतना चाहिए, तो तू ना, तू उधर ही रुक, मैं 2 महीने के लिए आती हूं उधर, मैं दिखाती हूं उसको, तू उधर ही रहे." Oh my goodness, you can imagine, you know. Are people in control? Can you control what people say about you? What people think about you? You have nothing. Are situations in your control many times? No. The guy who was batting was expecting an in-swing ball. And that's what the bowler bowled. And one gush of wind, an in-swing becomes an out-swing. And he's caught out. क्या हो गया? बॉलर ने बराबर, उसने तो इन-स्विंग डाला, इसको भी लगा इन-स्विंग, बीच में हवा आ गया बस. हाथ में आपके. Lot of things, situations, people are just out of our control. How many of you think question paper is in your control? अरे so excited. And when things go wild, na, I'll tell you what happens with us. I'll tell you what happens with us. This is what happens with us. You know? A little bit. This is what happens with us. See? See how it forms up? We react. The stimulus of a person sledging against us, criticizing, pulling us down, envious of us, conspiring, politicking, makes us react and form out. We start reacting also. And look at this. This is also sealed. The question is, do you want to be a 7-Up can or a Oxycool bottle of water? And I'm sure a lot of us would say, "Prabhuji, humko to dusra kuch suchta hi nahi hai, Prabhuji." Ladies and gentlemen, there are many situations which are completely out of our control. Don't consume your minds by something that you can do nothing about. Why are we consuming our minds by something that is absolutely beyond our scope to do anything? Shall I tell you something? A good 70% of our mind is occupied by these things. Statistic. 70% mind space is occupied by things that you have no control over. Kya karenge boliye? Learn this masterstroke, not to react, but to respond. Of course, easier said than done, you know.
Do you react? Like a 7-up can? Or do you respond? Like that water bottle? Is the question that we all have in front. And thus, in our life, we will always have a stimulus and we can choose to respond, because between the stimulus and response is our choice. Between the stimulus and the response is the choice. Sledging to Sachin Tendulkar is a stimulus. And his response is, he's been a water bottle his whole life. Without reacting. He wasn't an automatic water bottle. He has chosen to be a water bottle. The nurse did not give birth to a Sachin Tendulkar in the maternity ward. Well, gya tumcha Sachin gya. Century marunas aala hai gya. A Sachin wasn't created in the maternity ward. A Sachin was created by choice. A great personality is not born in the maternity ward. A great personality is born by the choices that one makes. And therefore, when there are all kinds of stimuli, we have to learn how to respond. Easier said than done again. If we are not strong spiritually, it is impossible. If we are not strong culturally, it is impossible. All this sounds great and good, and we know, yes, I want to do it. I can't be a can of soda. I want to be a water bottle. But is it so easy? No. That is why coming here is so important. That is why chanting mala is so important. That is why reading the Gita is so important. That is why these foundational ethics of spirituality are so crucial in this age. As all of you are going to be successful in your own areas of life, if not cricket per se, you know? And thus, we have to learn how to respond. One man, an expert batsman, 5,000 years back, had an opponent in him who was so envious, sledging. He was sledging. And this man, this batsman, hadn't done much, little bit something. Out of hunger and thirst. And this bowler called Shringi was sledging, calling names against the emperor of planet Earth, Maharaj Parikshit, the grandson of Arjun and the Pandavas. Sledging, calling him a low-class person, calling him all kinds of things, words. And he threw a googly. A googly that would make anyone react. Maharaj Parikshit was cursed. Cursed that he would die in 7 days and seven nights by being bitten by a snake bird called Takshak. Dead, burned to flames by the bite of this venomous flying serpent called Takshak. This personality, Parikshit, because of his spiritual practice and Krishna consciousness, did not become a soda can. He could have reacted and counter-cursed. He had more power than Shringi to counter-curse. If he had to do sledging, he would have been better. He didn't do. Maharaj Parikshit decided to be a bottle of water. By utilizing his life to surrender to the Lord and benefit others. And that is when he came to the banks of the river Ganga. And Shukdev Goswami spoke the Srimad Bhagavatam to Parikshit. Thank God. Because that's how we learn what the master strokes of life are. Our Vedic literatures and our books have it all. All we need to do is look at it from that perspective and we will see it there. You know? My goodness. Therefore, my Guru Radhanath Maharaj, he says, don't ask the question why. Why did this happen to me? Ask the question how. How should I deal with it? For that question why, either there are no answers or there are no satisfactory answers. Why did the in-swing ball become outswing by a gush of wind? Do you know? How will you ever know? I was dancing in that kirtan in Udupi and the ground was unleveled. How did I know? There was a carpet on top of that. Would I know? Am I Paramatma to look behind?
underneath that carpet there will be unleveled ground. I was dancing in the kirtan. And a strong jerk and a Jones fracture. Why? Why did it happen to me among so many people? We are all cribbing and complaining and crying all the time. Why me? Why did this happen to me? Why? To that question, why? Either there are no answers or there are no satisfactory answers because there are factors beyond our control, which is not an assessment of the opponent, which is not just based on practice. Ek hawa ka jhoka future badal deta hai. You know? And therefore, Radhanath Maharaj says, malaria ho gaya na? To doctor bolta hai, malaria ho gaya, dawai khao. Bola, nahin, main dawai nahin kha sakta. Kyun? Nahin, kaun sa machhar kaata pehle batao. Bola, are duniya mein itna machhar hai, you don't have any access to find out which mosquito. Will you ask which mosquito? How many of you would want to know which mosquito has bitten you? Because of which you got malaria. I have had malaria 18 times in the last 19 years. 18 baar malaria hua idhar aake. 1996 mein 7 chakka aur 1 run. 7 times I got malaria. Main dhundu Radha Gopinath mandir mein kaudhar hai machhar. Kaun sa machhar kaata? Jab wo machhar milega tab main dawai khaunga. Therefore, His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj says, don't ask why. Why did the mosquito bite you? Why? Hare Krishna. There is something called as karma. A factor that's beyond us. After you have done everything right, you've assessed your opponent, you've done practice in your academics, in your cricket, in your giving lectures, whatever. After all of that is said and done, there is a factor that you have no control over. Success in your hands or what? No. There are factors beyond us, and then don't ask why. Because you will never get an answer. Something from beyond. Ask how. How to deal with this. I don't want to react. I want to respond. Why ke liye jab answer nahi hai na, botal banna sikhna chahiye. Tabhi shanti ka jeevan jiyenge. That is called a master stroke of life. In the game called cricket. Are you ready for the next one? The fourth one is called power of blessings. Yuvraj Singh. I was so impressed to see this picture. I was very inspired and impressed to see this picture because when you are a great accomplisher, to bow down in front of someone becomes very difficult. Jab khud hi kuch hai na, wo bhi itne young age mein, jaake kisi ke saamne jhukna, this is on the cricket, this is on the ground during a match, before batting. Submission, surrender to people who are better than us, gives us an ability to deal with things which are beyond our control. जो अपने कंट्रोल में हो तो प्रैक्टिस से हैंडल हो ही जाता है. व्हाट इज विद इन आवर कंट्रोल तो आई कैन हैंडल बाय प्रैक्टिस ओनली. बट व्हाट इज बियॉन्ड माय कंट्रोल, प्रैक्टिस डजंट हेल्प. ब्लेसिंग्स डू, गुड विशेस डू. एंड देयरफॉर व्हेन वी गो एंड सबमिट आवरसेल्व्स टू आवर सुपीरियर्स एंड प्लीज देम बाय आवर एटीट्यूड्स, वी रिसीव द फ्लो ऑफ देयर ग्रेस. We receive the flow of their blessings. I always tell this story. It's my favorite one. His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj. I bahut acha lagta hai. Har bar bolta hu main story. I must have told her 10 times. I'll tell 100 times because I love the story. My Guru Radhanath Maharaj, he had gone to America. So he returned from America. And one of our senior devotees, Mr. Rishikesh Mafatlal, Chairman Mafatlal Groups, Krishna Chandra Prabhu is his spiritual name. So he went to receive Maharaj from the airport to drive him back to the temple. And one of our very senior devotees, Govind Prabhu, our temple president, is the senior most brahmachari in our temple. Very learned, wise soul. He also went. And then Krishna Chandra Prabhu was driving, Radhanath Maharaj sitting in the side seat, passenger seat, and Govind Prabhu sitting in the back seat, and they were coming to the temple. And a policeman, Mama, he started whistling. So then, Krishna Chandra Prabhu waited. So he knocked at the window. So Mr. Mafatlal Krishna Chandrapur, he pulled the windshield down. Tumhi signal todla. Said, nahi todla sahib. Abhi main baga na. Mala mahit nahi. Tumhi signal todla. License diya, license. So our Govind Prabhu was sitting behind it. Kaya mama, Maharaj evada saha mahinya nantar American one in Bharatala aale, tumhi ata asa karnar ka? Maharaj aale, tumhi ata asa license mangnar? तुला काय नाही महाराज असं गाडीमध्ये जातात मग लायसन पण द्यायला पाहिजे लायसन द्या सो देन ही सेड अहो कुणाशी बोलता तुम्ही हे मिस्टर मफतलाल आणि नुसते मस्त मफतलाल नाही फार जास्त अध्यात्मिक आहेत ते असं नाही करायचं मामा अच्छा ठीक आहे लायसन नाही मग पावती फाडा 1000 रुपयाची पावती फाडा बोलला काय महाराज तुम्ही महाराजांकडनं पैसे घेता महाराजांना पैसे दिले पाहिजे दान हो तुम्ही असं काय दान घेता तुम्ही त्यांच्याकडनं असं तुझ्यावर गोविंद प्रभू इज आर्ग्युइंग विथ हिम So then he was so frustrated that nothing is happening. He came on the other side where Maharaj was sitting and started knocking at the windshield. So Maharaj opened the windshield. And then he put his hand inside and grabbed Maharaj's hand. And he's putting it on his head. Laisan detna hai, paise detna hai, ashirvaad tari de aata. He's asking for blessings, you know. Oh my God. Not just in the game of cricket do we need blessings to hit a 6 or a 4. That's all okay. But in the game of life, we do need blessings because things don't go our way, ladies and gentlemen. This young man, at the age of 30, in the year 2011, got cancer of his left lung. Haath mein thodi hai apne. Jo control mein hai, usko practice se bhi chal jata hai. लेकिन जो कंट्रोल में नहीं है वो केवल आशीर्वाद से ही ठीक होता है दिस मैन हैड कैंसर ऑफ हिज लेफ्ट लंग एंड ही वेंट टू इंडियानापोलिस एंड आई बिलीव सम अदर प्लेस इन द यूएस 3 or 4 कीमोथेरेपीज टिल द ईयर 2012-13 बाय द टाइम ही वाज ऑल रेड एंड ही मेड हिज डेब्यू अगेन इन क्रिकेट एंड हाउ ही हैज मेड व्हाट इज द टीम नेम दिल्ली डेयर डेविल्स ऑफ विच प्रवीण अमरेजी इज द कोच राइट You are, yeah? I read today. Not because I knew you were going to come. Later I came to know, but because I wanted to know about him. So I read, Delhi Daredevils purchased this man for 16 crore Indian rupees. 16 crore deke wo team se ek team mein le liya. Aise nahi aata hai practice se. It needs submission. It needs a certain attitude by which we get blessings. Are you ready for the next stroke? Lesson number 5 from cricket. It is the small things that make a big difference. Hai na? Tuk tuk khelna bolte hai na usko? Lage raho. Tuk 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 tuk. Chalte raho. Hai na? It needs a lot of patience to do tuk tuk. There's a lot of patience to play tuk-tuk. You know why? Very simple. Because when you are excited to hit a sixer and a four, not easy to play tuk-tuk. And you must know one thing, that you can't hit a sixer always. You can't hit a four always. Har ball mein, har bar jab aapka balla chalta hai, to chokka nahi lagta. Har bar balla chakta hai, to chakka nahi lagta. Keep the scoreboard ticking. You can't wait only for fours and sixes. Keep the scoreboard ticking. Bola Prabhu ji, maine engineering kya hai? Main to Infosys ke bina main gaunga hi nahi. Are chup. Wo chakka hai. Tu pehle Shambhunath ke yahan paan bana jaake. You know, don't lose opportunities. Keep the tuk-tuk going. Small things only make a big difference and the score keeps on going. And then the last ball is a chakka and you win. Lagan. That guy, Amir Khan. Last ball hai, one ball and 6 runs needed. I'm sorry, 4 runs needed. Chauka. And this guy, gaawala hai wo. Seedha chakka. And that British fellow runs to catch and
catches the ball and jumps. We won against these gawalas.
Only to realize that he was outside the boundary. I never saw this man. Tell me this. मैं कहेगा क्रिकेट विकेट आई डोंट नो एनीथिंग अबाउट क्रिकेट अगर रजनीकांत को मारना है ना लास्ट बॉल है और 24 रन चाहिए क्रिकेट के हिस्ट्री में ऐसा कुछ होता नहीं रजनीकांत खेलेगा तो होता है वो बॉल मारता है और बॉल के चार टुकड़े होके बाउंड्री के बाहर जाते हैं 24 रन में जीत गया इंडिया विंस ओ माय गॉड When Rajnikant is the coach for the Indian cricket team, they won FIFA. Oh my God. Small things make a big difference in life. 1987, American Airlines, running through major losses. In 1 year, 1987, they saved $40,000. And that was a lot of money then. And they saved that $40,000 simply by eliminating one olive in the salad served on business class, not even economy. Business class ke har salad se ek ek olive kam kiya, $40,000 bachaya. Tuk tuk, khelte raho. Chakka chauka marne ka avsar aayega. Chakke chauke ke liye ruko mat, clean bowled ho jaoge. And have great communication. है ना communication होता है तभी वो बराबर run खेलते हैं वो भागा ये भागा ये भागा वो भागा communication दो कभी तीन earn this merit. Don't think I will chant 16 rounds of Hare Krishna mantra only when I pass my exam. वो छक्का है. आप टुक टुक खेलो. मैं रोज एक माला जरूर करूँगा. खेलो खेलो. एक एक माला करते रहेंगे तो आएगा एक दिन छक्का लगेगा 16 माला होगा. डोंट वरी इट इज द स्मॉल थिंग्स दैट मेक अ बिग डिफरेंस. यू मे थिंक व्हाट इज दिस चांटिंग ऑफ हरे कृष्णा जस्ट रिपीटिंग अ मंत्र व्हाट विल इट डू इट इज द स्मॉल थिंग्स एंड अपेरेंटली वेरी सिंपल मंत्र एंड अपेरेंटली वेरी सिंपल प्रैक्टिस ऑफ फिंगरिंग योर बीड्स विल चेंज द क्वालिटी ऑफ आवर लाइफ फॉर श्योर. The next master stroke is the power of attitude. Any sport, anything in life is about attitude. Attitude nahi hai to gaya. Positive attitude nahi hai to gaya. Rone ka nahi. Rone ka nahi. Ro ro ke thak gaye. Rone ka nahi. Kuch bhi hua to. Har jar mein rona kya hai? Bachchu hai kya? Abhi babies to keep crying with all things that happen in life, but we do. With the little things we do, usne mera gulab thukra diya. Are to thukra diya to dusri bhi hai. Kya ek hi thukra diya kya? There are hundreds of people to get married to in the world. Jai Shri Radha Gopinath Lalita Vishakha ki jai. Gopal ji ki jai. Shishi Gaur Nitai ki. See, they have raised their hand. Chakka. You know. No problem. And therefore, attitude is very... One man, he had only 8 hairs left. एक आदमी था पूरा टकला हो गया 8 ही बाल बचा उसका और वो बार्बर की दुकान में गया नाई की दुकान में तो द बार्बर वाज सो फ्रस्ट्रेटेड सीइंग ओनली 8 हेयर ही सेड इसका चोटी बनाऊं कि शेविंग करूं तो दिस गाय वाज सो पॉजिटिव बोला नहीं डाई करो व्हाइट हो गया डाई माय हेयर इट हैज बिकम व्हाइट एंड देयरफॉर पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड इज वेरी मच नीडेड. 2007 वर्ल्ड कप फाइनल्स. In World Cup, Sachin Tendulkar went on a duck. With whom? Against whom? Bangladesh. Against Bangladesh. You know? And then Sri Lanka. Aisa jhapada na ho. For someone who is successful. Such a slap on the face. But it's not that you are always victorious in life. Duniya ke hamesha aisa hi bol dalenge, aap chakka marenge. कई बार आउट होंगे कई बार LBW होगा कई बार कैच आउट होगा कई बार हिट विकेट होगा कुछ ना कुछ चलता रहेगा. Therefore, the right attitude is needed. There on the play field, he was so depressed. This is his interview. I read it. He said, this is it. I'm done. I cannot play again. he came back home and met his older brother, Ajit Tendulkar. And Ajit Tendulkar said, "No, Sachin, no giving up in your attitude. Victory or loss should not stop us from putting our effort. Success or failure is not what we do things for. We do things to serve. We do things to contribute. We do things to love. We do things to express our compassion to the world. And if we are successful, great, God's grace. And if we are a failure, God's grace, because we grow through such failures." Ajit Tendulkar told Sachin, "Don't give up. Envision yourself in the year 2011, holding the World Cup. We need encouragement. We need mentors. We need guides. We need gurus. We need counselors, because we give up. We generally tend to just lose hope when everything is not going our way. We fail. And that hope comes from people with maturity and wisdom. Spiritual guides.
Guru ki jarurat kya hai nahi to? Aise hi jee sakte hain. Apna man to bowling kar raha hai, man ke out hote raho.
That is why we need spiritual guides. And thus, attitudes. To be positive.
Sab log ka bulb nahi jala hai na, aapka jalaye rakho.
Don't turn your attitude off. Others around may or may not listen, doesn't matter. And this man had the humility to work under a captain who was 14 years younger in cricket.
Koi ustad aake kisi junior ke samne khelna na, bahut mushkil hai. If I speak and I give talks and a younger person comes and sits here and talks, it's not easy to sit and listen. It's not easy. But teamwork is not about who is big, who is less. Teamwork is not about who is in the position and who is not in the position. Teamwork is about we are together to win. Who leads? By the grace of God, whoever has that position at this time, let him lead.
And we are happy to follow. A good follower is a good leader.
Only those who follow well can lead well. Those who do not follow well are only hypothetically thinking that they are leaders. And they burn out people under them. They burn out people. They tarnish people. They criticize people. They hammer people down with their words, with their behavior, because they are egoistic.
Good leaders means good followers.
If I am even willing to work under a junior of mine who qualifies for that position at that point of time, that is great attitude. Great attitude. And if we have that attitude, believe me, our life is a success. Otherwise, if we are only position driven, one day position will go away. It must. It must go away. You, me, anyone. One day position will go away. If you are position driven, we will be frustrated. If we are service driven, team driven, we will never be frustrated, because we are happy to work with anyone, under anyone, because position doesn't matter to us. Contribution matters to us. You know, and therefore, leadership is not about positions only. And on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, there was one batsman who was giving up. The opponent team was Kauravas. And what bowlers? Bhishma, Drona, Kripa. What bowlers? Karna, Shakuni, expert googly men, leg spinners. ऐसा है कि गूगली डालते थे ब्रह्मास्त्र वरुणास्त्र और बैटमैन ने देखा उधर कृष्णा सेनयोर उभयोर मध्ये रथम स्थापय मेच्युत यावदेता निरेक्षेहम योद्धुका मानवस्थितान कैर्मया सह योधव्यम अस्मिन्द्रण समुद्यमे हे प्रभु टेक माय चैरियट अमिड्स द टू आर्मीज Because I wish to see who are all there to bowl against me. Abhi dekhna kya? Sab dekh ke ho gaya. Abhi batting karo. Assessment sab ho gaya. But ji nahi. We give up. And therefore the Gita was spoken by Lord Krishna. Why? To learn three words. Never give up. Hell or high waters. Never give up.
when we are purpose driven to serve God and serve the world, can't give up. Srila Prabhupada, at the age of 70, traveling to America on a cargo ship, not a passenger ship, had 3 heart attacks on board. He could have turned back. He could have come back. He had only 40 rupees in his hand, which was not even a dollar in a trunk of books. Life threats in New York. Seasickness on the ship. Leaders don't give up. They see challenges as opportunities to grow and contribute. Srila Prabhupada started the International Society for Krishna Consciousness and came with a bang in trying to convince so many and inspire so many to surrender to the lotus feet of Lord Shri Krishna. That is the power of Gita. He translated the Bhagavad Gita as it is so that people don't give up in their lives, in their purpose, and eventually they don't give up their spiritual purpose in life. And thus, the 7th lesson. First one, assess the situation. Second one, practice. Third one, react or respond. Fourth one, power of blessings. Fifth one, small things make a big difference. And 6, power of attitude. And the 7th one is character versus achievements. You can keep playing, you know. खेलते रहेंगे खेलते रहेंगे खेलते रहेंगे खेलते रहेंगे और ओवर कॉन्फिडेंस आ जाता है कई बार. 4 चौका लग गया, 4 छक्का लग गया तो ऐसा ओवर कॉन्फिडेंस आ जाता है कि मैं कर सकता हूं. और जब ओवर कॉन्फिडेंस आ जाता है ना, 1 रॉन्ग डिसीजन इन बैटिंग एंड बैक टू द पेविलियन. बैक टू द पेविलियन. देयरफॉर डिसीजंस, राइट और रॉन्ग, मैटर अ लॉट. आई वॉन्टेड टू बी अ डॉक्टर इन माई लाइफ, यू नो. I wanted to be a doctor in my life. Kya ho gaya, wo alag hai abhi. Wanted to be a doctor in my life. I came back from school one day. I was in standard 8 and came back from school, and I told my mother and my father, today Madam Monica dissected a frog in class and I couldn't handle it, so I went to the washroom and puked out. I remember, ulti kiya tha main. Yaad hai, achhi tarah se yaad hai. मैडम मोनिका ने जब मेंढक को काटा ना उधर, तो मेरे से रहा नहीं गया. आई वॉकड आउट ऑफ द क्लास एंड वेंट एंड प्यूक्ड आउट इन द वॉशरूम. सो माय पेरेंट्स टोल्ड मी डॉक्टर बनेगा. हरे कृष्ण. डॉक्टर उल्टी कर रहा है इधर खून देख के. ग्लैड आई डिडंट मेक दैट डिसीजन. आई वुड नेवर बी एबल टू हैंडल. 1 रॉन्ग डिसीजन वुड हैव चेंज्ड थिंग्स लाइक एनीथिंग. I had done things well. Academically, it was well. Went to College of Engineering, Pune, COEP, did my electrical engineering, worked with Hewlett-Packard, HP. Things went well. And I made 1 more decision. To quit all of that and come here, which none of you have to do, because that's not the master stroke of life, essentially. I made that stroke in my life. I made that stroke in my life because what I had received was so valuable, I couldn't help but share. I couldn't help but assist my guru in trying to share. रोक नहीं सका मैं अपने आप को. और अभी इधर आके ऐसा मत समझना कि डिसीजन ठीक हो गया. एक गलत डिसीजन हो गया ना, बैक टू पवेलियन. क्या स्पिरिचुअल गुरुज, स्पिरिचुअल बाबाज नहीं होता उनके साथ? 1 रॉन्ग डिसीजन, 1 मोमेंट ऑफ इनअटेंटिवनेस एंड बैक टू पवेलियन. जेंटलमैन, डोंट एवर बी ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट योर पावर्स. Don't ever be overconfident that I can do it all. That is when what we call as Maya catches us in that overconfidence. And therefore there is a need. You know what? Life is a moment by moment decision. Her moment choice karna padta hai aur right decision lena padta hai. Aur kabhi kabhi isme nahi, kabhi kabhi bahut bada gadbad decision le lete hai ji hum log. You know this man? Hansi Crony? South African, what a cricketer, what a cricketer, what a man in cricket. And you have heard in Delhi, I was caught when achievements mattered, not character. When achievements matter to us, we sell our character. We sell our souls for those extra bucks. It is very easy to make a buck.
very tough to make a difference. And we shouldn't just make bucks, we should make a difference in our lives and in the lives of others. Hansi Crony, my God. I to main ek hi photo dala hu. There are pictures of his crying. Crying. He confessed. First he was not agreeing. Then he confessed for taking money. Such greed. When achievements matter, integrity is gone. When we are driven by material achievements, we don't care for our integrity because money is what matters to us. If contribution matters, then character is what we keep. When service is what we want to do, character is what we keep in our lives. You know, this man died in an air crash, plane crash. Can you believe? Can you believe it? Cricketer of his caliber. The newspapers reported his death in a plane crash on the fourth page as a small little column. If he would have had that character, it would be front page. Front page news that Hansi Crony killed in an air crash. Gentlemen, just for those extra bucks, don't sell your values. Don't sell your character. Don't sell your soul for those few bucks that will buy you a few extra space, a few extra this or that. And that is why today many times when we find people even in any sport succumbing to such greed, we lose respect for such people. Because we are not concerned about their making money, we are concerned about their being clean. And there are many cricketers in the history of this country and all over the world who kept a clean record. When their character is clean, the world will remember them like that. And even if they get caught in a controversy, a scam, but they have not been involved, by the power of blessings, things which are beyond their control, they will come out clean and free. Time will tell. It may take time. Pandavas came out clean and free. Were victorious because they chose to keep character over achievements. And thus, we see, don't go by achievements and cups and medals and sell yourself for those. Character is important. How many know this man? Seldom we will know. His name is Mr. Kalyan Sundaram from Chennai. Koi charisma nahi hai iska. Koi presence achievement nahi hai iska. Character kya hai? Every year of his life, every month's salary this man gave as charity. Ek bhi paisa apne naukri ka khud nahi rakha. All money he gave. And people don't know him. He's a hero. An unsung hero of this nation ki jisne ek kodi rakha nahi apne liye. He gave all his money away for education of poor children. Character inspires. It inspires and it leaves a legacy for many, many more in the world to come who will follow suit of such people. And therefore we find Jatayu. He fought against Ravana, didn't he? And when he fought against Ravana, what mattered to Lord Ram was not whether Jatayu was victorious. What mattered to Lord Ram was he tried. And Arjuna in the battle was victorious. In both cases, one externally failed, another externally won. Victory and defeat is a part of life. For people who are of substance, external victory and defeat doesn't matter. Character and sincere effort matters. When God sees you, He doesn't see whether you're a success externally or a failure externally. He sees your sincere attitude to serve and to do the right things, you know. And thus we find in the Srimad Bhagavatam incredible masterstrokes of life. Lesson 8, which is the last lesson for today, the last one for this evening, is from 2011 World Cup victory. India won against Sri Lanka. Yuvraj and Dhoni hugging each other. And the captain of Sri Lankan team, see his smile. Jeeta kaun? India. Has kaun raha hai? Wo. Celebrate others' victory. The Bhagavad, the Chaitanya Charitamrita says, don't be envious. We should celebrate others' victory and take pleasure in others also going ahead. When we take pleasure in others, the Lord blesses us also to go ahead. Jalne se ashirwad nahi milta hai. Dusron ke utkarsh mein sukh lene se ashirwad milta hai Bhagavan ka.
And therefore, the last lesson for this evening is, no matter how much we succeed, when you play in the stadium, when the match is over, do you stay in the stadium? No. You leave the stadium after playing the game of life to come back home, where there are relationships, where there is people who love you out of affection. This world is like a stadium. Play the game of your life. Sometimes victory, sometimes defeat, sometimes century, sometimes no century, sometimes tuk-tuk, sometimes chakkas. Sometimes hit wicket, sometimes no ball. Don't worry, ये तो चलता रहेगा life में. खेलते रहो. भगवान को साथ में रखो जैसे अर्जुन ने रखा और मैच खेलते रहो. And once the game is over, when life ends, this is life on wheels. बचपन से लेके अंत तक गाड़ी पे ही चलते हैं हम लोग. When the ambulance carries us finally to the crematorium, till then, this is what happens. तो ये स्टेडियम में खेल खेलने के बाद क्या ये स्टेडियम में ही रहोगे? मैच खत्म होने के बाद यहां से स्टेडियम से निकलना पड़ेगा. जाओगे कहां? That is called Bhagavad Dham, Golok Vrindavan, the spiritual world. That is the purpose of the game of life. That as we finish our match and get out of the stadium, we want to go back to our home where eternal life awaits us with our Master and our Lord, Shri Krishna, where we can serve Him and live with Him. You know? And do you know something? Apne yahan se ek kuch nahi jayega saath mein. Century leke jayenge saath mein. कुछ नहीं जाएगा साथ में. आई वेंट टू लंडन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. आई वेंट टू लंडन, ठंडी था उधर, हमको बोला समर है. पहली बार गया मैं और हम लोग कोई स्वेटर फेटर लेकर नहीं, बोला गर्मी में कोई स्वेटर पहनता है. एंड वी वेंट देयर एंड स्टूड देयर, मायसेल्फ, राधा, गोपीनाथ प्रभु, एंड देयर इन लंडन दैट पर्सन हु केम टू वाज मेंट टू रिसीव अस 45 मिनट लेट आया. बस कुल्फी बन रहा है हमारा उधर. तो देन राधा गोपीनाथ प्रभु टोल्ड मी, प्रभु जी I think you should make a call and call him. Where is he? That person who's picking us up. तो बोला ठीक है. I pulled my phone out. Sorry, international roaming ही activate नहीं किया. I said, प्रभु जी फोन नहीं चल रहा. बोला पे फोन से करते हैं. So we went to the pay phone and no one had told me, this is my first time I'm going, no one had told me that I should change my money to pounds. सब रुपया है और एक फोन कॉल नहीं कर सका. तो राधा गोपीनाथ प्रभु बोले, वो इंडियन आदमी लगता है, उससे मांगो फोन थोड़ा. मैं बोला जिंदगी में मैंने कभी किसी से ऐसा हेल्प नहीं मांगा, लेकिन अभी आप बोल रहे तो जाता हूँ. सो आई वेंट एंड आस्क्ड, वो भारत इंडियन था, बोला थोड़ा फ़ोन हमारे साथ स्वामी जी, ये ठंडी लग रहा है, वो हमारा आया नहीं, थोड़ा फ़ोन करके पूछूँ क्या कितने बजे है. बोले अरे स्वामी जी मेरा भाग्य खुल गया, आप मेरे फ़ोन को छुओ, मेरा बिजनेस अच्छा हो जाएगा. यू नो ही इज टेलिंग लाइक दैट. सो आई टुक द फोन एंड फॉर्चुनेटली द गाय हु वाज मेंट टू पिक अस अप केम एंड देन वी डिडंट हैव टू कॉल देम. But I learned a lesson. When I travel overseas, this currency doesn't work there. Change my currency here so that I can use it there. The currency you have in this life, your money, your talent, your family, everything, कुछ नहीं चलता है आगे. जब ये स्टेडियम छोड़ के जाते हैं तो चलता है. कन्वर्ट कीजिए. कन्वर्ट योर ऑल वॉट यू हैव नाउ इन अ वे दैट वेन दिस मैच एंड्स एंड वी लीव द स्टेडियम, अपने साथ करेंसी होगा जो उधर चलेगा. एंड देयरफॉर ISKCON इज अ करेंसी कन्वर्जन ब्यूरो. यू नो यू डू योर सर्विस हियर, यू नो यू कम, यू चांट हरे कृष्णा, टेक टू कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस, रेंडर सर्विस, डू व्हाट यू कैन फॉर कृष्णा. Everything you do will be converted in a way that will be understood there. And these are the master strokes of a life which were taught to us by our captain, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. And by His grace only can we truly understand all the master strokes. I wish to thank you all very, very much for your kind attention. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.